Hey guys, what's going on? Langan Plays here, back again with another video as usual. And today, I wanted to release this video yesterday, actually, as we're getting into it. And it's Red Dead Redemption 2, 1 year later. Now, it's still mind-boggling me. I just went back to play the single-player game. It took me about 2 weeks, I think, usually. I think that was the first time it took me as well, 2 weeks to beat the game. And this time I went for the side missions as well and everything like that. But it's just crazy how fast time flies, you know. It's just, I can't believe this game's already a year old, and it's one of my favorite games of all time. Definitely my top five, maybe top three, actually, not thinking about it. It's just an amazing game as we go over it. All we're going to be doing today is to be talking about the main story and everything, and how the game still holds up today, and its standards, basically. In my personal opinion, the story mode is still 10 out of 10. There's nothing you can really do. I mean, there's a couple things I would have done differently with the game. It's probably just build up more relationships with the characters at the end of the game, obviously. We're going to be talking about spoilers as well, so that's a thing. I might as well just say it, but I felt like we should have got more missions with, I want to say, John Morrison, and just in general with Arthur, because those two didn't really have a relationship till the end of the game, toward, I want to say towards Sisica, like the prison break, obviously. After that, it's like, it was very strained, and you didn't really do much with those two. I wish they kind of drove the relationship a little bit more with those two characters, because obviously, as we know, Sadie and Charles actually had a lot of time, which I love. And honestly, Charles and Sadie were like one of my favorite characters of any video game, right? They're just very fun characters to use and everything like that. I think Charles is one of the coolest, actually, now thinking about it. But and Sadie was an awesome character as well. She had like fire in her eyes, basically, and it was just a fun character to use. But other than that, that's what I had to say about the story mode. But we will be talking about the story mode through this whole thing. But one thing I do want to talk about today is the multiplayer, or the online. Now, the online isn't too bad here, but there's just not much you can do. It's not like a Call of Duty game where you just hop on every day to, get things. Online, there's really nothing much. All you do is, like, get weapons and everything, obviously, but it doesn't feel rewarding for even doing some of the missions. I mean, maybe some of you do actually feel like you're doing some of the missions, but the one big update I really did like about what they have done lately is probably, like, the little bounties and stuff like that you can do, where you can be, like, a hunter and get more money and stuff like that. I think that's a good idea. I think they just need to, like, push forward, like, a little, I used to say online story mode. I think that'd be fine. But other than that, I think it would be a pretty solid game, like for the online mode. It's not like GTA where you're like, oh, here's this and here's that, right? Where you can do anything you want. This is, you're kind of subjected to do certain things because you can't really do much, right? I mean, you could do like the 16v16 modes and stuff like that, or 30v30 or whatever it is. There's a lot of stuff like that. Or the Battle Royale mode. It's really not a Battle Royale, but there's a bunch of different things you can do online, but it's not really fun as compared to GTA 5, but that's my personal opinion there. But yeah, let's go about the story mode, my god. Now, I did make a review on this game last year, and I did give it a 10 out of 10, which is funny. And honestly, man, I just went back to play this, and I felt like I was more connected to Arthur this time. I don't know what it was, but the second time I didn't really feel, the first time I didn't feel really connected to Arthur as much. But this time I was like, damn, dude, this is really sad, right? Because he really didn't want his character to die, obviously. He's a very changed person towards, I want to say, like, the first half of the game. Not even, but he actually starts to care for every single person and everything like that, you know. Because obviously at first he's just like some rude guy at first, right, as we seen. But he actually does change his way, and then the group starts, like, mangling apart, I guess, in a way. And he does, like, step up a lot, honestly. It's him, Charles, and Sadie that really do, and Morrison, obviously. But I don't know. I feel like they could do another game with, like, Charles or maybe Sadie Adler. I think it'd be a pretty cool game now, thinking about it. Maybe where they could do something with Charles. I mean, they could do DLCs of those characters. I don't think you could do a full-flesh game, but maybe you could with Sadie. I'm not sure. But supposedly there is a Red Dead Redemption remake. It's not a remake, but all they're going to do is, like, revoice some of the lines, obviously, and talk about Arthur and stuff like that, and possibly another ending, people are saying, if this is true. And I've been hearing this rumor for months now. I'm going to put the link down in the description as we're talking about Red Dead Redemption 2, but it's kind of crazy that this is the thing now. Like, if we do get another one, supposedly it's coming out for the PS5. It's just a Red Dead Redemption remake, basically. But it's not too bad, I guess, if they do a new ending. I think everybody would kind of like that as well, because it depends on your good honor from the ending of the second game, basically. Or the first game, basically, it is now thinking about it. It is Red Dead Redemption 1, but I don't know. I think they just had a good idea with this, you know. I think they can still go a long way with the next, Rockstar game with Red Dead Redemption. There's so many things they could do. They could talk about so many different characters, but that's just my personal opinion. They could even do a whole thing maybe about Dutch. I mean, I don't know if they could really do a full-fledged game on Dutch, not thinking about it. I mean, they really did push his character towards the end, and I think that's what I kind of really liked about the game. They show him breaking through the game, obviously. Like, where he has, like, so much stress, basically, and he can't really comprehend many things going on around him. And I think that's what I really enjoyed about the game. They showed, like, every character breaking. The only thing we really didn't get a lot about is Javier Asuelia and, obviously, Bill Williamson. I don't know why we didn't get as much with them. I think Bill had 3 to 5 missions, and I want to say Hobby Hero only had like three, because you had the one on the island, and then you did one of them in the beginning, I'm pretty sure, and then there's like another one later on. So I'm not sure if we'll ever get to him again. We'll see what happens to that guy. I mean, we know what happened to him obviously in the first game, but I don't know, it was kind of strange. Now looking back at this game a year later, like I kind of like dove into the game a little bit more to check some things out, and I mean, the game still holds up, honestly. It's coming out for PC as I'm making this video. And honestly, if you guys have not seen it on PC, it looks amazing as of right now. They're sharing some pictures and some of the gameplay. And honestly, I just cannot wait just to see how it really looks on there and just how everything feels. And some of the graphics on there actually look really good for the cutscenes they're sharing pictures for. So that's very exciting. But yeah, I just really wanted to talk about this, you know. It's kind of crazy to me. There's a lot of badass moments too, like the Braithwaite, like when you go to the manor and everything. That was one of my favorite parts of the game. Just like, oh, was it 14 of you? Or like, I think it was 12, but you all just walk up and everything like that. And Hosea's character was also really, like, enjoying. Like, that's what I'm saying about the Rockstar games, you know. I'm not a big fan of the GTA games like that. I think GTA 5 was probably the best GTA game in my personal opinion. But I would have to say, Rockstar's best game ever would have to be Red Dead Redemption 2. The story mode is on point, there's nothing you can really complain about. There's a lot of different things to do in the story mode, which I can't believe there was actually so much, right? Because after I beat the game last year, I even do the strangers and everything. This time I went through almost all of them, I have like one left. And it's crazy how fun they are too, I'm not even gonna lie. There's a lot of things you can do as Arthur and John. I think you have to do, I think, two strangers as Arthur at least, I'm pretty sure. Maybe three of them actually, because there's Hamish and then there's like a couple other things. And there's a lot of cool things you can find out what happens to the character at the end of the games. And I really like that. Now going back, you can find Tilly, I remember. You can find Pearson and Rains Falls. And you also can find Mary Beth, who's like a writer now, which is kind of cool in a way. And it's just really cool that you can go back and check it out. And I think that's why they did such a great job with this game. I think it was the best-selling game actually of 2018, so I wasn't really surprised about that. I mean, obviously, it's a Rockstar game, everybody's gonna want it anyway. And the game was fantastic from head to toe. There's nothing I can really complain about till, like I said, several times already, but let me know your thoughts and opinions down below. Now, I can understand if you want certain missions with certain characters, let me know. If you want to see more with certain... I mean, they're all pretty fun to use. I like some of the side missions, though, with Uncle and everything like that you can do with him. There's many things you can do with Uncle I didn't even think about. Like, I think there's one with, what's it called? I don't even think it was a main mission, actually. Oh, it was a main mission. It was where you were with Williamson and all those guys, right? And robbing the banks during the game were pretty fun as well. Like, we're going to Valentine. I forgot about that one. That was one of my favorites. Now thinking about it. And that was just a really cool, honestly, going through the whole game. And even the Micah character, a lot of people really liked and enjoyed. I don't know. I think Micah's character was alright. You know, obviously, he's the main antagonist through the game. That's just probably the second main antagonist, I'd say. He didn't really get into your way until, like, maybe the end of the game, really. Because he wasn't really on anybody's side at the end. Then he joined Arthur's side a little bit at the end, as he seen. Then as he said, Dutch, I gave everything. Or I think he says, I gave you my all or something like that. And he's like, oh, damn. And he walked away from Micah, so. I don't know. I think this game, it still stands a 10 out of 10 to me. Let me know how you feel about it 1 year later. I think I missed a couple things, obviously, like hunting and everything like that. I think hunting during the game is really fun as well. I didn't think you'd get paid a lot at just having, like, a good carcass or whatever they're called, right? Or a good animal good animal body, right? And you can do a lot of money with that. And you can make a lot of satchels, which I made as John. I didn't do it really as Arthur, because I guess I didn't really care as much, but... It was a pretty fun game. I liked the side missions, though. It was Hamish, basically. They were pretty fun. And then he had the one who he taught how to hunt. That was awesome as well. But the only thing is, I don't understand why John doesn't really talk about Arthur much. I mean, I guess because he saved his life or something. He didn't really like to talk about it. That's really strange, you know. Because he says that like several times throughout the game anyway when he plays John during his story mode. But yeah, that's all I wanted to really say today. Let me know your thoughts and opinions down below. How do you feel this game holds up? It's still one of the greatest games of all time, in my personal opinion. It's probably my second favorite game. And the length of the game was amazing from head to toe, I gotta be honest. If games can go a length like this and have a great, meaningful story, then that's all that matters, in my personal opinion. The gameplay's obviously great. It just has, like, basically a GTA vibe to it. And all the weapons were fun to use and everything like that. But... it's just crazy, man. I hope they do another Red Dead Redemption game somehow. Maybe they could do something that has Jack Morrison, obviously, at the end of the first game. But, I don't know. We'll see how it goes. Other than that, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video, so peace.